Hey guys, how are you doing? I'm George Castro. Today we're going to Wall Street in New York. I'm going to teach you 5 negotiation techniques. Okay, let's go.
Let's go.
We're going to New York. We're going to Wall Street, where the economy of the country moves the whole world. Wall Street. Hey, Jairo, how are you?
How are you?
Good to see you.
Thank you.
We're going to New York, Wall Street. When you call someone and you leave a voicemail message, sometimes people do not retrieve their messages. Then you have to follow up with a text. One of the things actually that I've been doing is, this is a video message. Hey Natasha, how are you doing? This is George Castro returning your phone call. I called you, I guess you were busy. I also texted you and you have not responded. I'm sending you a video call. Call me when you have a chance, thank you. I'm going to click send. And I'm going to send it to the intended party. If you communicate with people like this, you become more diligent and the chances of getting your phone call returned increase substantially. No one is doing this. I don't understand why. In the real estate business, as competitive as it is, the more diligent and efficient that you become in trying to communicate with people, the more money you are going to make just by doing a simple video call, which is what I'm doing here, you see? It really works. And I'm going to teach you how to become a great negotiator, how to assemble agreements with people, how to persuade them to do what you want them to do. So guys, I'll see you there. Hello, New York! Okay, guys, we're in New York. I will see you in Wall Street. Follow me. Look what I just got. Here. Hey, Stephanie, how are you?
I'm okay. Are you on the way back to the office?
What do you have?
Okay, Shabita, the lady that went to the open house.
Yes.
She wants to submit an offer for that home. I am waiting on Fernando for her pre-approval.
Okay, so actually she wants to put a contract.
Yeah.
Very good. Schedule an appointment with her at 7 p.m. and I will help you write up the contract. And I'll help you with those two clients.
Okay, thank you.
Wonderful. Two contracts in one day, one real estate agent. I love it. You know, the energy, you know, making things happen, doing things, and actually making yourself available for the opportunity. Like I said before, today I'm going to teach you how to become a master negotiator. Take care of the downside and the upside will take care of itself. I always go negotiating something, thinking and expecting the worst. If you expect the worst, if you live with the worst, the good will come by itself. Tip number 2, psychology. Always understand who is in charge. Beware of your voice inflection, how you stand up, your body language. That determines who is strong and who is weak. And that is actually important. Show authority when you're negotiating. A very important trait. Tip number 3, maximize your options. Never get attached to one deal or one approach. Always keep a lot of balls up in the air, because if you lose one deal, you have other deals to fall on. So always keep assembling deals and never get emotionally attached to one single transaction. Tip number 4, know your market. I like to think that I have instincts. The real estate agents that know the market, that understand how people behave, how the economy fluctuates, are the ones that are producing 95% of the real estate transactions. So that building over there, right across from the George Washington Monument, sits the building where the New York Stock Exchange operates. Let's go. Trades. People trade, people sell, people buy. People buy low and then they sell high. Amazon, Google, Apple, you name it, everything happens here. The economy of the entire universe operates and trades here in this building. Number five, use your leverage. Never show weakness. The worst thing that you can do is show that you're desperate. Then your opponent will smell blood and you will lose. But never become complicated. One of the things that I have seen many real estate agents do is they become too complicated. They ask for things that are not even relevant to the real estate transaction because they take it personal. Don't be emotional in a real estate deal. Remember that you're representing the best interest of your client, but sometimes saving your client $40 a month doesn't mean that your client is winning. Come on!
Hello?
Hey Norville, how are you, big guy? I received your contract. What is the listing price of the property?
$310,000.
And I noticed that you are offering $40,000 above asking price?
Yeah.
Was it accepted?
Yeah, it's accepted. That's why I sent it to you.
Congratulations, big guy. Let's get together tomorrow when you have a chance so that I can help you assemble the contract.
Okay, all right.
Okay, big guy.
All right, thank you very much.
Okay, take care.
I'll see you tomorrow. Yeah.
Very good, thank you. You know, Sunday and a lot of things are happening. Another contract from another agent. Someone who actually transferred his real estate license from a major franchise company to Premier Homes. And one of the things that he said was that even though he'd been in the real estate business 7 years, in the few weeks that he had been in Premier Homes, he had learned more than in the 7 years that he had been working with other companies. Now we're going back to New Jersey. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, make comments, like, and tell me what you want me to talk about next time. Have a good day.